Do you notice anything interesting about these four numbers? That's right, each one equals 2. 2 over 1, that's 2. 4 divided by 2, that's 2. 6 divided by 3, 2 again. 8 over 4 is 2. So there are lots of different ways to write 2 as a fraction. But what about 1/2? Can we write that as a fraction in lots of different ways? Let's check it out. We'll start by finding 1/2 on the number line. Of course, we know how to do that. Start with our number line, and 0, and 1, and we break this into two pieces. And of course, 1/2 is right at the end of the first piece. Now what if we take each of these two pieces and break each one into two smaller pieces? Now, of course, I'm breaking the segment between 0 and 1 into quarters. This is 1 over 4. This is 2 over 4. This is 3 over 4. Sure enough, 1 over 2 and 2 over 4 end up at the same spot, so it looks like those two are equal. Now we also could have broken up each of our two smaller pieces into three smaller pieces each. And now we're breaking the number line up into sixths. So this is 1 over 6, this is 2 over 6, this is 3 over 6, 4 over 6, and 5 over 6. And we see that, sure enough, 3 over 6 ends up in the same spot on the number line as 2 over 4 did and 1 over 2. So it looks like these three are all the same. Now we didn't need the number line to see this. We could have done this with arithmetic. And we do that by taking 1/2 and multiplying it by 1. That's right, so we just multiply it by 1. But not just any 1, a very special 1. Here's the 1 we're going to multiply by. We're going to start with 1 over 2, and multiplying it by 1 doesn't change anything. So we can multiply 1/2 by 1, and it'll stay the same value. The 1 that we're going to multiply by is 2 over 2. 2 over 2, of course, that just equals 1, and we know how to multiply fractions. The top, multiply the top, so we get 1 times 2. Multiply the bottom, so we get 2 times 2. 1 times 2, of course, is 2. 2 times 2 is 4, and sure enough, we see that 1 over 2 equals 2 over 4. Now, when we go in the other direction, we start with 2 over 4, and we write the top as 1 times 2 and the bottom as 2 times 2. What we're doing here is we're taking out the common factor that 2 and 4 have. They have the common factor 2. We separate that into its own fraction. 2 over 2, of course, is 1. That goes away, and we're left with 1/2. When we go in this direction, we say that we're simplifying 2 over 4 as 1 over 2. And when we do that as much as we can, we take out as many common factors as we can, we say that we've written the fraction in simplest form. So 2 over 4 in simplest form is just 1 over 2. Let's try that out with a slightly more complicated fraction. We'll try that out with 36 over 48. See a common factor? Yeah, that's right. They're both even. We've got a common factor of 2. So we can take out a common factor of 2. 36 over 48. We can write the 36 is 18 times 2. And the 48 is 24 times 2. You see our common factors here of 2. We can break that out into a fraction that is just 2 over 2. So we have 18 over 24 times 2 over 2. Again, all this is multiplying fractions. This fraction equals 1. 2 over 2 is just 1. So 18 over 24 times 2 over 2. Of course, that's just 18 over 24. Now, usually I don't go through writing this step right here. I know that this is going to turn out to be 1, so this is going to go away. So what I'll do back here is I'll just cancel my common factors. When my numerator and my denominator are both products, and they have a factor in common, the 2's, we know that they're going to cancel and just leave us with 18 over 24. All right, so we've got that now, and we're done. Oh, that's right, we're not done. These two still have common factors. I mean, they've got 2, they're both still even. You're right, they're both divisible by 6. We can take out a common factor of 6 here. So we can write this as 18 over 24 is, the top is 3 times 6, the bottom is 4 times 6. And again, we can cancel out this common factor, and we're left with 3 over 4. So it's perfectly fine to simplify in two steps. Oh, you're right. Yeah, we could have done this in one step. We canceled a 2, and then we canceled a 6. We could have done that all in one step. We could have just canceled a 12. 36 and 48, they have a common factor of 12. 36 is just 3 times 12. 48 is just 4 times 12. We cancel out the common factor of 12, and we're done.